Hi everyone. I am so glad that you're here. Welcome. Real quick, I'm gonna pin that message here. Welcome, Stacy. You're the first one in chat today. Yeah, let the festivities begin. I'm excited. Temple, welcome. Helene, welcome. Hello. Peg. Now, Jell, your name was tell me your name once again. I was going to be able to write everything down and I did not recall. So, Jell, tell me your real name again. And then I'll write that down. Laura, so glad that you're here. Francine. Chrisella. Loretta. Drizzly, North Carolina, California. It's raining here. I live in Oregon. So, Danielle, thank you. I have you down right here. Aren't you from the Netherlands? I think you're from the Netherlands. And I'm going to write your name down here. All right. And then we have Sharon. Hello. Yeah, Washington State. Stacy and I are feeling the Pacific Northwest weather. Shannon, welcome. I think this is your first time, Shannon and Ken. Yes, I am. For friends and family, I'm Jelly. Okay, well, thank you guys so much. It's wonderful to have you guys here. Some of you are new. I always love seeing new people in chat. That's always exciting. And I'm really excited about today. And I feel like we made pretty good progress on the piece. You guys, it has been such a great live replay. You guys are all watching. It's one of my most watched replays in 48 hours. So that was really great. I had so many wonderful comments from you guys. I really appreciate it. What I talk about the most when I'm done here with my family and my friends is just what an exciting community that we're building here together. Just being able to connect with other people who love art and are creative, and to also be able to talk in real time with real answers. I think it's been the gap that has been missing, and I'm really fulfilled that it's getting filled. And so it's been wonderful connecting with you all. And what an amazing community in chat. I've always said I've started this out really wanting to be chat forward, and this has just been a lot of fun. So let's see here. It's snowing. Wow, that is a big change. That's a lot. I don't want to see any more snow. We're almost in full spring here. So that has been really, really nice. I've missed it. We have the full four seasons. So it is in full spring. So that feels really good. So what I wanted to get started with today is the one thing I don't have that I think this is probably going to be at least a three-part live. And so I don't have my computer to be able to print out where I'm at now and show that at the end. My ink ran out and I have it ordered, but it didn't arrive in time today. So I think by the time we're at the end of this one, I'll be able to do two printouts for the last one and be able to show you guys the journey and how far it's come at the different stages. So I think that'll be fun to see, but I was hoping to have it today and my printer will not even print unless I have all the colors full. So it's like, are you kidding me? So yeah, so I'm excited to be able to have that for you. I'm also going to be sharing a really fun, unique technique with you today using the gold pastel. I love incorporating the gold into my work. I haven't really worked much with the other colors, and I just have always been really drawn to gold. So this is going to be a lot of fun. I think it might surprise you a little bit, and so I'm excited to share that too. My five sisters are amazed with your demo. Five sisters, Loretta. Wow, they're all watching. That's pretty cool. That's awesome. Well, thank you, Stacy. I'm glad that you're excited about the gold. Yeah. I'm screen shooting now. Yay, gold. Yeah, if you want to, you know, take a screenshot of where we're at right now, that can really help you even see the progress that it's going to go on. I'm going to focus on the hair today and blocking in everything. So we're going to at least get everything blocked in. I have a sweater on, but I think I'm too hot. So I'm going to take this off. And I am just going to get started. I think I might start a little bit with the gold just to break the ice. And what I do is my friend Ivy, a lot of you guys know Ivy Newport. We live locally. She's one of my good friends that live here. Well, we go out and she's really good at finding these like cute containers for things. I was never really like that, but she got me to get this like cute little candle holder. And then I put all my gold in here. And what I'm doing is I'm basically, I know this might horrify some of you, but when you've been doing it for over 6 years, I got bold and I'm a little bit experimentative, and so is Ivy. And so I actually have an older gold and I actually bust some of it off and scrape it into this little container. Now, if some of you guys have seen some stick artists and some other pastel artists, I've worked in this in some of my lower layers, as you can do an alcohol wash. And you can actually even do watercolor, but you can even put down a rough thing of pastel and then you can use alcohol to break it up for like a random abstract, like landscape work. They do it a lot for landscape. And what it does is it allows for you to have an underpainting on like an ivory paper. And so you're not just struggling with this ivory peeking through everywhere. And I think it's one of the reasons why I like black so much, because I don't mind black peeking through. But on the ivory, that's what it's used a lot for. So it's a common technique, but I don't think this part's that common. And what I do is I have a little sprayer. It's a fine mist sprayer. I've showed this before in my other lives. I keep the box so I can show you guys. It's off Amazon. It's the an ultra fine mist spray. I first bought these for my plants in my studio, because I have a whole bunch of plants. And then I was like, well, why couldn't that work as an ultra fine mist for alcohol? So I have the black one, has my alcohol in it. And then I just shaved some of that in here. I put a little bit in already to get it going. I'll put a little bit more in there. And then I actually use a little paintbrush, a miniature paintbrush. And I get it to the liquid state where it's not dripping off my paintbrush, but it's thick. And if you wanted to get a little bit thicker, you just wait a few minutes, because alcohol evaporates really quickly. And this is how I make my little, I think you guys can see that pretty good. And this is what it turns into, a paint. So really, when you think about mediums, even acrylic or oil pastel or pastel, watercolor, I'm sure some of you know this, but a lot of people don't, is that the only thing that makes them different, they're all made from pigment, but they all just have different binders in it. So the pan pastel is what makes it so special, is it's a really high density pigment. You're basically working with pure pigment. There's not a lot of binders in there. And when you're working with sticks, they have more binders. So they're not as ultra fine and ultra soft like pan pastel. So like in anything, you can mix like alcohol in there, and it's not really a binder, but it works well with it. And then it evaporates off and dries. And so you could use any colors you want. Not that I would necessarily want to paint with alcohol, because it is a strong smell. And I just use it for touches and details and underpaint work. So I'm going to look at chat real quick, because I've been talking for a while. Let's see here. Do you spray fixative between layers or at the end? You know, actually, I don't spray any fixable, Danielle. I use a sanded UART pastel paper. And this paper actually is specifically made so you don't, any of like pastel matte, any of those, anything in general, you really don't need to spray a fixative on. Fixative for some of the lower layers, I will use for techniques that I want to keep the lower layers to not to move or pull up. I'll use it for that. I'll use it to push my darks back darker. But I don't want to use fixative or seal or anything on my final layers because it will take the whites and totally knock them down. I've had students that, even though I say it multiple times in a class, they still have it in their head they gotta fix it because they're so used to having something they can touch. And watercolor is the same. You have to frame it. You could probably touch that. It doesn't, you know, come up, but you have to frame all of the pastel work behind glass to protect it. It might have a little bit of shedding, but over time it doesn't shed. And the only difference when framing is you will use a spacer, or you can, where it lifts it off the glass, or you use a reverse mat. So no, I don't use any fixative or anything like that. And I just tap off the work, get rid of anything that's loose and extra. And I store it in between a folded piece of glassine, in between two pieces of cardboard. And so that's how I store my pieces after I'm all done. I do mount my pieces onto mat board. I have it linked below for the video of how I mount all my pastel. If you want to level up your pastel experience and make your pastel even easier to work with, it allows me to photograph it flat for social media. It allows me to ship it flat, super easy for framing. So I do mount all of my pieces before I work on them. All right, let's see here. Okay. Yeah, so you can mix the gold or any of the pastel really with the alcohol in it, and it turns into paint. A lot of people will draw directly on here and then use the alcohol to mix it up, kind of like a watercolor underpainting. I'm just using it right now to put in some details. So I have my paintbrush, and I'll just pick like a spot that I want, that I know I want gold in, and I'll just start laying that in. And the benefit to doing this, well, number one, if you don't have enough alcohol in it, it won't, it'll be too thick and it will gob up, and you don't want to have to go over it again. So that's just something to learn, like how much alcohol you want to put into it. And the other thing is that when you're using gold pan pastel, especially on the black paper, if you have, it takes like a couple layers of the gold pan pastel to be solid. So I will take and sometimes do all my gold first, like right around the black stage with my blacks. But if I want my blacks to still move around, I'll use the gold and I'll put that down first where I know I want to use it. I have to pre-pave and plan ahead. But, and then I'll spray it with fixative, because, or like, even if it's just alcohol, I'll do a light spray of the gold, and it seals it to that level. And then I can put another coat on without it lifting up. But when I paint it on, I get a really opaque application, and that's what I really like about it. And why I'm doing it right now is because I want to bury the gold and make it infused into the piece. I don't want it sitting on top of everything. I mean, those are fun to do little gold details and have them sit on top at the end. But in the hair, I want it to, I want it to be where I can go over it and draw over it and bury it a little bit. So I'm just doing a really light, like I'm not putting it down heavy, application. I think you can see that pretty good there. That's pretty close up, especially with those of you watching me on the big telly. I love that. I think some of my Australian people aren't here, at least the first half, because the time zone changed and it's 6:30 in the morning there now. So I'm just dipping in and tapping off a little bit. I'll probably have to add more alcohol here in a bit to keep it thin enough to work with. And I have a piece that I did this on, and I'm just going with that and doing a similar look because I really like this. I've used gold watercolor in some of my pieces, and the gold, like that fine tech, I've had a lot of fun with that. But it once it's on your paper, you can't put pastel back over it again. So you have to be at your later stages to do that. Let's see. So the consistency that I'm probably would be able to say where it's at is like it's not dripping off my paintbrush, but it's definitely almost there to where you can see where it's going to be thin enough to take off. And if it starts getting clumpy, then I'm going to want to put more alcohol on it. So you definitely want to practice, you know, practice on something first and get. I also have these miniature paintbrushes, which I don't have them in the links, but I will go update the links after the live. But these are paintbrushes that are for miniatures. And I think this one's is like a zero. It's like the smallest little paintbrush. No, this one's a 2-0. So it's pretty tiny. And but I just love putting it in here. And then you're going to see the journey of how I bury it and incorporate it into the piece. And, you know, when you put it on top of pastel, it will leave a little halo sometimes. I don't mind that. It has a little cool halo because I'm doing it for my little orbs. Sometimes it does that and sometimes it doesn't. So I'm trying not to be too structured with it here and just go through. I'm probably not going to do this whole thing. I just want it in some areas. I'll probably do this little thin line.
Isla, oh, you're new. Welcome. Yeah, I'm thrilled that I made it finally. Isla from WV. I'm at my sewing machine creating art, an art wearable for a friend. Cannot wait to get back to Pan Pastel. You're my favorite pastel inspirational guide. Oh, thank you. Oh, your piece sounds really cool that you're working on. Wearable art is definitely a fan of wearable art. I used to work in upcycling cashmere. So I would buy cashmere at the Goodwill bins. We have these bins here. And then I would take it and dye it and then upcycle it into cashmere pillows. And I was into that for quite a while. And but I had to finally pick because I was doing so many things. I could never stay focused. So I'm just going around and I'm picking a few of these. I like it when it's thinner. And now it's starting to get thick. So I need to put more alcohol in it. And then it goes a long ways. And then I just stirring it back up again. And then it's going to start its journey of, I think when it starts running down the side and not staying in a drip, it's definitely at the thinner point. Cause you definitely want it to be thinner, not thicker. Because what happens too, is that when your piece gets stored away, if it gets too thick on there, it starts coming off. I would say that's the only time I've had a little bit of a challenge with the pastel. I got a little bit of, right here, I got a little bit of eraser. So I'm going to get rid of that. And I have a little hair on my face. It's still there. Okay, there we go. So this is definitely patience, and I would say this whole technique was brought about when I really knew I did a few things and I could go, okay, I'm going to try this out. And it's just evolved over time. I'm probably going to do the big hoops. Yeah, the cashmere was a lot of fun. I have probably 100 pounds of cashmere, and they have holes in some of them. Some of them I found really good sweaters, and we had to dig a lot. But once you kind of knew what you're looking for, it would come up a lot, and a lot of people don't know how to repair a cashmere sweater. And then I would felt them down and felt them in the dryer, and then that would make all the edges not fray, and then I could cut them up and quilt with them. So my initial thing was I wanted to make a huge cashmere quilt, but yeah, I ended up just doing pillows. So you can see how fun this can be. And the cool thing is once the alcohol dries, then it ends up just being pastel, you know. But you definitely have to be careful for it getting too thick. Like that was a little bit of a thick application there. I'll have to probably go over that a little bit with my lines, because I really want my black lines to be there. So you have to keep kind of adding alcohol. Ooh, thank God I didn't do that on my painting, but I just hit my paintbrush against the easel and it smeared. This is a lot thinner, but let's see. I think it'll be fine. Yeah, I went a little thinner. I like that better. I used the 90, but I think the 70 would work too.
Thank you, Stacy. Oh, do we have Jonas? Welcome, Jonas. Hi, Dawn. It's and everyone, it's nice to catch you live. Hi, Jonas. Welcome.
So I don't want to put a ton in, because see, I can even put more in later, but I'm just trying to get my initial layers in there.
I do like these little holes to be black sometimes, but it's also fun to hit it with like a gold. I've been pen wag for many years, watching meetings, presentation online during and after the pandemic. Peninsula Wearable Art Guild. Is that what PenWag stands for? Like,
I've never heard of PenWag before. Okay, so I'm trying to think. I'm going to put some right here. And I can always go over this with color if, for say, I didn't want it. I can still erase,
which is fun too. And then I think I want to do one more. I'm going to do this thin line right here.
And then I'm going to do this line right here. I put quite a bit of alcohol in this last one, so this might end up being all of this right here. Yeah, I totally agree, Stacy. You know, it does make them more regal or like goddess kind of like, and I dig that. So I think that's one of the reasons. I have a lot of pieces that I've done with gold in their hair over the years, and I just love how it looks. And yeah, if you feel like it's anything's too much, you can definitely take it back a little bit. And I'm gonna, I think right here, that's the other thing. You have to like watch where you put your brush back down because it'll get all over. And I think I'm gonna put another line in up here and maybe go right here. I just like to keep the black in there because that just keeps it kind of consistent. And there we go. Thank you, Stacy. And so the alcohol will break down other things down below too. So like it'll even go into the black. So if you put too much on.
I feel like I got quite a bit in there. I might just do a little bit more. Oh, have a great night, Danielle. I'm so glad that you showed up. That's awesome. I'm glad that I've inspired you to play and try out the gold. And thanks for stopping by and saying hi all the way from the Netherlands. That's so cool.
Okay. I think I'm going to just continue this line up here. And I'm going to put a little bit in this one. And I'll have to mess with that and get that to blend in. I also did this really cool part where I actually put lines in. Let me see if I can get... I had another paintbrush that actually did some thinner lines. Let me see if that one's over here. I'll just go on the edge here. So compositionally, like I'm thinking you're right here. This is the focal point. So there's pattern right here and that will be pretty powerful when I pull a color in between it. And so I really like that. I've done another piece that has that on there. That's why I have it up here for reference. But I also like to repeat some of that somewhere else. And I'm thinking I might want to do that down below here. I like it when the lines aren't so thick, So I'm trying to get a thinner application there. And then I want to go here.
Too much gold is probably not a thing. That's so true. You should, like, I have some older pieces that I was like all about the gold, man. It was so much fun. And I definitely agree. Totally cool with all the gold. I'm a regal color lover, bronze, copper, gold, champagne. Yeah, it would be cool to see some of the other colors done with this. I just end up, you know, really have been really enjoying the gold, so I just keep on working with it. And I've tried many types of golds. Like I said, I've done the watercolor too, and I've also used like Sumi ink for my blacks, and I played around with that, and the Sumi ink would kind of sit on the surface and no longer be, it fills the grit. I think it was the Sumi that I used, yeah. Okay. So you can see how just adding a little bit of that in can really add some pop, and I'll probably add some more in a few different areas. Like, I wouldn't mind maybe putting it in here. I'll probably end up going on the finishing and adding a lot more spots to tie it all together. But when you do things in layers, you're going to have the more of a harmonious relationship with the gold, with the piece, and it's not just all going to sit on top. Yeah, if I recall, I think the Sumi ink just sat on the surface, but what was kind of cool is I put the Sumi ink down and then I was able to paint over with this pretty well. I'm just trying to remember. I know it was one of the inks that I used that sat on the surface. You definitely have to test them out first before going all in. You know, I have that mixed media background, so I'm always, you know, trying different things, but I end up just coming back to the pastel in the end for the most part, because I'm learning how to work with it more and more, like using the alcohol. So this is one of those stages that give you a guidance. Like, it's meditative, it's a warm up. I'm not having to really think too hard once I've made my decision. And then it allows me to kind of warm up to the piece and get going. But there's a lot of freedom in this moment. And so it really helps me kind of figure out, well, what do I want to do next? You know, so I think I'm pretty happy with that. Right here, might carry out this line just a little bit more. Michelle, good morning. You're here. That's awesome. Welcome. I'm so glad to see you. I kept hearing about mixing alcohol and pastels. I rushed out and bought pastels and found out it was isopropyl alcohol. Just kidding. Like, what do you mean? Like, it? Oh, I get what you mean. I'm a little slow. I'm a little slow. You wanted to mix alcohol, have a few drinks. I'm thinking that's what it is. Hello. You know, I'm using a lot of bandwidth doing this, so I get a little bit of an excuse for not catching that right away. Oh, man. Yeah, welcome. I'm so glad that you're here. Oh, Laura had a question. Let me go see real quick. What makes you choose gold pan pastel over the golden paint? Well, that's a great question, Laura. The reason why is because the gold pan pastel works with the piece. If I'm doing just black pan pastel with that style that I do where I use the eraser and I'm using just black, a lot like charcoal, I can add paint at different layers, you know, usually my finishing layer, and know where it's going. With this, using the gold paint, if I put the gold paint down here, pastel wouldn't stick to those areas again. The gold paint would fill up the tooth and make it slippery. So doing this, you're going to see that I can work with all the pan pastel and bury things and use the pencils and you know, integrate it into the piece, because it is the piece. It's pastel with pastel, because the alcohol evaporates, leaving behind just the pastel. So it works more harmoniously with the whole painting. I mean, at the end, you could put some paint on, but it doesn't work as well with it. Like, even if I put the alcohol down, you get a little bit of a ring, and most of it evaporates, but quite a bit of it kind of stays. You definitely have to do some tests and learn how to use it. I've been playing with the gold for a few years now. So I think I have most of what I want for gold in there right now. I'm really drawn to maybe having it in here, but I can always put more in later. So I think I'm going to go with that and just see how it feels. I might do, like, I like to do these into thirds, so I might do one more, like, up here. So I'm always trying to mimic and get that feeling of mixed media with pastel, and I really feel like I've accomplished that in my flow and the process, and so it feels really diverse, but I'm actually using the same medium all throughout. So we have the gold. I don't think I'm going to add any in here. I thought about doing the ring in there, but I don't think I'm going to add any there today. We'll see. I mean, if anything, I would add some dots, but I don't really feel like I'm going to add gold. On my all the other pieces, I don't usually put it on a face. So let me check chat here. No problem with using both kinds of alcohol. Okay. Oh, you guys are funny. Bailey's to cover all time zones. That's great. That's great. Stacy. I like that you guys are silly. That's fun. Okay, so I'm going to start thinking about what colors I want to put in here. And sometimes that can be a little bit, you know, intimidating to go, okay, I've done all this. Now what am I going to do? I might start here and I know what I want to do here. So it's just like in school when they tell you to answer your questions first. So I will probably go with that first, because I know I want this to be a fern, and we'll get that put in here, and then we can move forward with the next step. So I'm basically just blocking in. So it's all about layers. Everything, it isn't just a one shot, you've put it all down and then you're done. I usually put about three layers on each piece. Pastel happy hour. That's what I need to have. Welcome, Autumn. I'm so glad that you made it. That's awesome.
So I'm just gonna get this all in here and then I can put more detail in the tattoo. This is how I get my tattoo fixed. I gotta get the courage to get a tattoo someday. Thank you, Stacy. I really can't stress enough how much it's for beginners. A lot of people stop too soon. They'll be like, well, I feel like I'm just done with this and I want to move on to the next. And some of it, you know, it's really hard to push through the layers at times. But I think what pushed me through is that my last layers are usually my most fun. So I work really hard to get to that mark making time, and getting through the blocking in stage can be challenging because nothing really looks how I want it to look. Like even with this fern, like I'm going to want the fern to look a little bit more like a tattoo. Like I feel like I might have brushed it down a little bit. So I might go and reinforce that a little bit here. Sometimes with the black, it's like how much is perfect and how much is too much. I want the black lines to show through unless I bury them. I'm going to be going over here too. And everyone too is, you know, I'm hoping that you get inspired to use some of these gems in your own journey. And then, you know, really think about leaning into what parts of the things that you're trying feel good. What do you want to do more of? Do you like more structure? Do you want to even have more realism? Or do you want to lean in towards more of the abstract? So that's been a big conversation for my own journey that has helped me decide, you know, where's my joy? You know, like what's bringing me the most joy? So,
I know, Laura, that's one of the things keeping me from getting a tattoo is my skin's starting to get thinner. And I think that's a little bit frustrating as I'm like, you know what? Is it going to look that good 5 years from now? Because I'm 51. With my tattoo, is it all gonna like look like a blur? Like, yeah, I have really felt my skin change and all of that since I turned 50. It's like, maybe not. So maybe I'm just gonna live through my tattoos through the art. Oh, Lori, you made it. Welcome. Oh, Peg, that's a great question. So most of these lives, I'm working on a 9x12 and I'm having to limit myself because I really, really, I think my favorite size to work on is 12x16. It's really the perfect size for me because I can do more full body. I like to keep my faces bigger and I don't like to work super tiny faces and things like that. So 9x12 is what I'm working on with the lives. I used to work on this size all the time, and then I stepped up to the 12x16, and that is my favorite. I think that's my happiest because I don't get sick of the piece as quick. I have some larger 18x24s that I'm working on, and they take me a little longer, so they sit a little bit. Like I have probably
four pieces sitting that I would like to finish, but I've also started this new adventure. So week eight, you guys, can't believe I'm on week eight. So now I got that fern in there and it's pretty dominant right now because I haven't really gotten them to merge and that's totally normal. Jonas Mark, I like the portrait and the colors. Thank you so much. I appreciate you participating in chat. My tattoo looks the same as it did when I got it. That's so true, Lori. I overthink things. I overthink things. So I'm thinking with this flower, I want to do some magenta in it.
My skin is crepey and drying out. A male neighbor pointed it out and mentioned sagging. Oh, I'm so sorry, Loretta. That's not nice. You tell that guy he doesn't need to comment on that. Goodness gracious. Lori, most of mine still look great, but the skin tears easier as we age. I'm older than you and Dawn. Okay. Yeah, Lori's 10 years older than me, but we were like, I can't even believe that.
It looks great on your arm, Lori. I have to remember that. I'm so glad you made it today. I hope you had a good day at work. So, a fun fact, well, a random fact about me and Lori. Is, well, Lori and her husband are the ones that got me to do it, but I have an alter ego and I like to game. So her and I, we play a game called Destiny together twice a week and we get on with the whole headset and everything. And we play together and her and her husband got me into that. And I first initially got into it because of my son. I wanted to be on there and learn what he was doing. And I never expected I would get sucked into it all. So we've been doing that for, gosh, I think 7 years. It's crazy. You're at the beach? Oh, good for you, Lori. She's been wanting to drive out to the beach for a while. She lives closer to the Oregon coast. And she actually lives on a slough. Really beautiful. I call it paradise. And she can see all kinds of, you know, eagles and birds. She's a birder, so. Okay, so I got. And it looks dark, that tattoo. And I'm not necessarily wanting it to scream like, here, I got a tattoo right here. I can always bring it up later. And so I'm just getting it blocked in.
Oh, you guys are really sweet. How fun. My favorite spot is Lincoln City, Oregon. Maybe we'll retire there.
Yeah, Lincoln City is really beautiful. I love to go to the ocean. Lori, what was it? Glen Eden? I know that was the one place. I'm trying to think of the place we went for your birthday, the 60th. That was really pretty. So I got that in there, and now I'm going to bring in what I want to put in the center. I have another one that I put a flower on. I think I did this orange. I'm just going to go with that. I can change it later. And if you notice, it is a little bit contaminated. My tool is getting a little bit dark. I'm okay with that because this is the bottom layer. Sometimes that's a blessing when it knocks it down a little bit. So now I'm just trying to think. I might bring the clothes. I might put those in greens, like this mint. Might just do a mix in here. This is the permanent green shade. And a lot of this is just patience of getting this all blocked in. I could have just done, a simple body, but I was like, oh no, I gotta have fabric. But I wanna abstract it out, and I think that's gonna be a lot of fun. And so at this point, I'm using a shade because I don't want this to be too bright because this is our focal point. And I'm just going to, and I already have black on this part. So that's going to put that back into like an extra dark. So when something's a shade and there's the black, it's just going to knock it down because of the pan pastel system and the way it's set up.
Glen Eden and Depot Bay. Thank you, Lynn. I'm so glad you like the hair. I love to change things up and just go with my imagination and use some structure. For those of you that are just here today, like I did use a reference for this one. This was my reference. But as you can see, I'll just use the core base for my reference, and then I change up a lot of different things. This is a foundation, and I like to build structure, and then I spend a couple hours drawing all of the details and changing it up and figuring out how I want the hair and that type of thing. So I get a lot of my references from Unsplash, so that's a great resource. But I usually will always change up some type of reference. That just keeps me excited. I'm really hoping I will get the hair blocked in today too. And then I'm thinking the third live will be all the merging of everything together. So I feel like with this cream, I brushed it down a little bit more than I normally do. So my black is getting buried a lot easier. And when I say brushed it down, I use my bristle brush. I don't want those lines to disappear unless I tell them to. Part of my creative process is building the structure and then breaking it down. Okay. So I have one. I'm going to mix in another green here. So you can see too, when you use the ivory, if I don't hit all of these lines, I have to be careful. I need to put that as a different green. I'm going to go a little brighter here. If you don't get all the color in there because there's no underpainting, then those things will peek through. And if you want to say like why I like the black the most is because any of these little peaks of color, you can see them all in here. When I'm using the black paper, that wouldn't bother me at all. I would not care because the black's creating depth and that's usually the shadow area. So if you don't use an underpainting here, then you do have to play with that and push that back. And that is one of the reasons why I like the dark paper the most. But, you know, underpainting, you can do watercolor under here too. If you do too heavy of a wash, it warps the paper. But you can do watercolor. But the problem I didn't like with the watercolor was that it was permanent. So if I wanted to erase something or put something over it, it wouldn't move again. And that was really frustrating. So I'm just rotating back and forth on the fabrics. I'll probably harmonize them together. I'm trying to think of what I want her body to be. If I go any colors that are, I might go bring in a Diayrlide green, or I could do a, I could do a purple. Well, we'll just see what happens. Yeah, the watercolor underpainting is a lot of fun. I did a lot of exploration with that. And then I ended up going, okay, I think I like the alcohol underpainting more because I like to make changes. I just do. The watercolor is fun too. You learn to work around it. I used it mostly with my abstracts. I'm thinking about doing that violet abstract that I showed you guys examples of one of these weeks. Okay, I might pop in some other colors here, and maybe that'll help me transition and think of what I want the bodice to be. I usually like my women to feel like that they're wearing moss. So I think I'm going to follow my initial gut and put a Diayrlide in there. And maybe another green. So, sometimes the piece tells me what it wants. I could go violet, but I think I'm going to go with this. So this is the Diayrlide. I'm going to just say that they're a guest appearance. And I'm going to put them over this. Well, I'll put them over this green right here. And then I also have a Hansa yellow dark. They're pretty close. They're similar, but it's just nice to mix it up. So I might leave that one down and just see how I feel about this one. This is a yellow green. It's one of my favorites. I mean, they literally call it Diayrlide yellow extra dark, but it's definitely in the green family. The Pastel Whisperer. Oh, you're sweet. So this blocking in stage definitely has, you know, we got to have the patience. I'll probably actually blend out this so it's not so strong. Yeah, I like that. And then I can incorporate it in and harmonize it. Well, I'm actually really excited. I don't have to travel this weekend. So I'm going to be able to work on my class and hopefully get one of the lessons fully filmed. I have everything pretty much drawn up, which I'm excited about. I had someone ask me for a tip, like a hint about my next class. So I'm going to give a little hint. I don't remember who said that last time. I read back on the chat and I realize I missed some of the questions. And my hint is that the name's going to be probably, most likely, Nurture Your Joy. And if you know me, that might be a good hint. So I have some pieces that reflect that, and I'm really excited to share it with you. Okay, so I've gotten that pretty much done, and I think I'm gonna go with a violet on the feather here. Maybe I'll do the magenta with that. So a lot of this stage is just choosing colors and remembering that pan pastel works as a system. So I can put colors on top of this to shift all the colors. And I'm basically blocking in so I can go have fun and play and scribble and things like that. I'm using the edge of the tool here, where I'm actually loading the edge of the tool, and then I'm dropping that in. And a lot of finesse and detail work will be in the pencils stage. Yeah, I like that. And then I can just think here a little bit of like, okay, let's just start popping some color. I just got to break the seal. So like if you've watched, a lot of you have been following me for a long time on here. Well, since the beginning of the YouTube, 8 weeks. And once I tap into one color, I'll go and hit it, you know, three times somewhere else. And that really helps kind of give me just permission to move forward. And I might mimic this flower throughout, but I think I want to use pencils for that. So I might go right here. Going into the hair, folks. I'm doing it. And I'm probably going to bring in some pencils earlier because they help break things up even more. Yeah, nurture your joy. Oh goodness, where do I sign?
Yeah, I've been wanting to do this class for a long time. And I love the symbolism of it. I think it'll be fun to show people that connection to art and teach them how to have that own connection with their pieces. So I'm pretty stoked about it. Okay, so see, I got three in there.
I got three spots of the hair. I'm gonna just start laying in a few more. And if I didn't have this body started, I wouldn't know that where I kind of want to go. And I have to have the face at a certain level because you don't know how far to bring stuff or not. No, leave it. I just got a package dropped off by Amazon. So they like to ring my doorbell. Okay, so like, for example, I know I want pencils to be in a few different spots, and one of them have this piece. I might do lavender right there. Well, you guys called it something else last chat. It was the purple pencil that I love so much. You called it like, I don't remember. I was going to write that down. So I don't know if you can hear the wolfing. It's a little sunny. Sunny, you're okay. We're all safe. We're all safe. So I'm going to actually put this in here. And this is where you can see that first, you know, where I'm working with the gold. And I want it to peak through, and it's going to harmonize that.
Oh, caput. Now, spelling it and pronouncing it are two different things. Caput mortem. I don't know. I love this color. I always call it a Mars Violet. You're fine, Sunny. You're safe. Okay.
So
one of the things that this always reminds me to share is that when you're trying to lean into abstract, that if you don't do something abstracting in the beginning or in your drawing, you have nothing to build off of. If I went and drew her exactly right here without having some of these mark makings and abstract work in the drawing, then I'm not able to go abstracted as easy. And I would say this is how I close the gap. So whenever you're learning something new, I like to describe it as a gap, and the gap's really wide. When you look at something and go, oh man, I want to start doing abstract. And then when you start doing it, you're slowly closing that gap. And so I would say, like, in a piece, don't try to go all out, but maybe just try to incorporate some of the things so you close that gap a little bit more on your journey. Because there was that time when I woke up and I'm like, oh my gosh, I just want to do abstract. And then trying to do it and actually doing it was two different things. And I got really frustrated in the beginning, and that gap was too wide. You know, it was just too big of a gap. And so we got to just realize that the art journey is about closing the gap with skills and techniques and time. It takes time and patience. So I would say that's one of the biggest things I've been able to express. And I'm not trying to overthink it here. I'm just trying to lay down color. A lot of times when I lay down color, it all works out in the end, because whenever I've used one color, I will incorporate it somewhere else. And so that's how I keep it working together.
I wish Amazon would ring the bell here. Yeah, they just started. They just started. Let me see. Okay, I missed a couple. The soft tools are one of the things that drew me to pan pastels. I'm kind of clumsy with stick pastels. Yeah, the soft tools, I think of them as totally like paintbrushes now. It's taken over 6 years, but I really feel like they're like paintbrushes. And welcome, Phoenix. I'm so glad you made it this week. I'm glad you're excited about the hair. I am too. Your dog barely barked at Amazon, yet my dog is on high alert now looking for your wee one. Yeah, usually Sunny barks a lot more. Like, I'm really impressed that he's being so calm. Cameron, my husband, was saying, you know, Sunny's doing pretty good up here during the lives, because I did have him down in my husband's office. So on this piece, I'm just kind of mixing in with using the pencils and stuff, because I want these lines to show, and they still have some peaks of white through them, but I want to have this be a little bit more structured, because I really like this flower. So I'm just making it all this color, and I'm going to probably add a few colors onto it. But when I do open-ended pieces, mostly always doing that, to move forward, I have to just start laying the color down. It can be intimidating.
So I have that in there. I might just keep that rhythm with the flower going. I love this color. It's a pit pencil. It's 124. It's a beautiful pinky fuchsia violet yumminess. Is that a name? Pink fuchsia yummy violet yumminess. I'm just going to, you know, be hired on to name colors for companies. No. Okay, so I have that one. And then I'll usually just try to find maybe another spot that I can put this in. And even though this is kind of a thick spot, I don't really care. I'll use the pencil. I do like to put pan pastel underneath a lot of this, but sometimes I just get where I just want to start laying down some of these other colors so I can play. And they're all the same medium, so it doesn't really matter.
So you can see how I've done three now. I'm glad you love the color. Oh, Temple, what did I miss? You got it. I think it's literally Latin for deadhead. Was originally made from mummies. Is that like the name? That cat pulp mortem? Because mortem sounds like mummy type stuff. Catapult mortem, deadhead in medieval Latin, was rich pigment varying in hue from burnt to raw umber, made primarily from white pitch, myrrh, and ground up ancient Egyptians and their pets. Lori, are you reading this? Lori would love this type of stuff too. That's so cool. Wow. That's awesome. Oh, you guys have been busy. Temple. You can add that to the delivery details. That's, oh, wow. It's all our positive energies. Pup feels, no barking necessary. It's a full chorus when Amazon comes to our house, scares some of the drivers. Well, I think Phoenix, you have the a lot of animals. Josie, Betty Boop, Abby, Normal, Aria. I think it's Darwa Grimalkin. You have quite a few animals. It's mildly mortifying. Oh, currently six. Wow, my dog goes bonkers when the drivers show up and CP. Okay, wait a second. Oh, how many do you have? Oh, you already asked that, Stacy. Okay, so now I've got this in. I might even tap some of this in down here. It's bright, but come on, look at it next to that yummy teal. Like, that's, I like that. I'm just gonna go and do like a line like this. So I'm just starting to really I like that. So I'm going to pull this pen out. Now I know I've used it and I really like that. And now I got to just start thinking about some spots on the hair. I'm just going to start laying in some color. I keep thinking I want to go pastel. I'm going to just do a little bit with the pastel and then I'll pop in some. I'm going to pop in a little bit of this Diayrlide in some spots. I'm just trying to think about where I want it. I think I'm going to go and just get it in there. I'm just going to start laying it in there. You get a little timid sometimes. You're like, oh my God, I don't want to mess something up. And then I like to start hitting it at a few different spots around, and then I'll just keep doing that with color until I feel. I might have to go in with this with a pencil. Of course, I picked this nice tiny little area. So you can see how that's going to eventually bring her outfit into the piece.
I also want to put green and red are pretty complement. I want to put a little bit of red in here. And I'm just thinking about where I want it. And I can always bring that red down. I might go with the shade here. If I go with the shade, it allows me to go up a level with details on top of it. This right side of the painting is always a little awkward for me because I can't move in front of the painting. I think that might be sometimes why I lean into the pencils a little bit more, is sometimes they're a little bit easier in some of these areas.
So now I'm just starting to lay in some of this red, and that's going to tie in some of the face and the pinks because I can bring that up along the way. So it's all going to look a little bit stained glassy and choppy, and that's just part of my process. I really love putting pinks and peaches alongside red. And you'll see I usually will split things up and have them be kind of spatially aware, and then I'll start bringing more in. Barking geckos. Yeah, you have like, don't you have like 50 of them, Laura?
No, I can't imagine barking geckos. I had lovebirds once, and I had two of them. I did have two of them. They are so loud, and they basically ruined my canary, because my canary had a beautiful song, but they will adjust to what lives in the house. And I did not know enough about birds. And oh my gosh, lovebirds are so loud. They are, and they're not a pretty bird loud.
When you start the drawing using the wolf, I imagine, do you use your clean hand stick or glassine paper to protect your hand to smear it? Okay, so when I'm drawing, let me show you guys. So, I don't know if this will show up. Yeah, that shows up on camera. So I draw this on a tracing paper using pencil. So I can erase, start over, do a whole bunch of different changes. And when I do that, I will put tracing paper over so it doesn't smear too much. But I'm going to go over it again because I'm making it into a transfer. And that's what the back is I use Pan Pastel to transfer it. So when you're working, I'm using this as like a sketchbook, and I just have a 9x12 pad of tracing paper, and I use it like a sketchbook so I can transfer my drawings when I'm done, or I can take a photo of them and enlarge them if I want, because drawing directly on the pastel paper isn't as fun all the time. So depending on what I'm doing, some things I'll draw directly on there. Thanks for the hearts. But when I'm on the tracing paper, it's so buttery and fun to just draw on, and it's also not precious. Using sketchbooks just make it too precious for me, and I don't get explorative. I'm way more explorative on craft paper or the tracing paper. And then the tracing paper is like another win-win. Because if I like something, I know I can just transfer it. So once I'm done with that, then I transfer it on, and then I go
It's all transferred on, and then the pastel is there, and then I go support it with the wolf pencil, and then I'll put a piece of paper over when I'm supporting it to not smear. So I hope that answers your question.
That magenta makes friends wherever she goes. It's so true, and if you know by now, that's my favorite color. Love, love, love. Yowza, that permanent red shade really pops. Yeah, I love the red. Cameron! Hey! Oops. Here, just a second, guys. I'm just gonna mute it while I yell. I don't know, there's like extra noises out there today. So I'm looking at this and I'm thinking, okay, where else do I want to put that red? I think I'm going to go bold and put it right here. Cameron, I'm so glad that you popped in. He's at a meeting right now. You are the sweetest man. I've been married for I think I'm 27 years and 26 years, 26 years. And he's so supportive. Thank you, Cameron. I really appreciate you. Oh my gosh, 50 with more eggs. Oh, thank you, Phoenix. I really appreciate that. Yeah, hit the like button, you guys. My last video did so well with all your support, the watch time, everything. I just really appreciate it. I'm still here. It's Michelle using a different device. Sorry, I had an issue with my dog Luna. I noticed her eye was very red. Aw, I hope she's okay. Darlene, welcome. I'm so glad that you're here. I think it's your first time in chat. Welcome. Well, I hope it heals quickly. Yeah, he's a keeper. Oh, you shared it on Facebook. What did you share on Facebook? Oh, the live. That's awesome. Thank you. That's really awesome. I've been, when you sign up for my free, for those of you that are new, I pinned it to the top. I have a free pastel membership area. And when you sign up for that, you also have the opportunity to sign up for my newsletter. And then I usually send out a newsletter every Monday reminding people of the live. I only send it out once a week. So on Thursdays, I don't really have as much reminders out there for people. But yeah, so if you sign up for my free pastel, remember there's two things you gotta approve. So say you do want the newsletter so you can get reminded of my lives. And when I have art for sale, I post that in my newsletters. So I'll be having that pretty soon, and new classes and coupons and all that stuff. So I'm ready to upload. I also have a Squarespace has changed and they have a new classroom that I get to start loading all my new classrooms in. So I have a new freebie that I'm going to be posting live. There's a preview of it in the free pastel area. And I'm going to have that live hopefully by the end of the month. That's not on YouTube. So I do try to post a lot. Like this is a lot on YouTube already, but I try to have an additional selection on my website. So I'm feeling that red going down right there. I might even bring it through right here. Don't worry, we love Sunny. I'm so glad. Thank you, guys. Oh, good. Do you guys know each other, Stacy, Darlene and you? Thank you, Darlene, for your kind words. I'm so glad you made it here. Is it how to frame using the spacers?
I am going to be framing a piece maybe this weekend, and I'm going to film it. And so basically, if this was the frame that was going, like, say this is the frame, and then you have a piece of glass, and that glass has gaps in it, so it covers your frame a little bit right there. And what you do is you put that spacer, you put your glass in behind, and then you put that spacer between the glass and the artwork. And that goes around the whole thing. And then the artwork sits on that and it keeps it from touching the glass. So like, let me see if I have a quick example. Well, those are all sealed. So I'm gonna do a video, but basically you're taking the gap of something that's not shown and you have a plastic spacer that sticks to it. And then that just allows you, and the only way I can frame them that way is when they're mounted onto the mat board. And so I will do a video of, you can also just put them in a frame, you guys, if they're your own personal painting. Just, you can just use a mat and put them in the frame. Just make sure you knock them off really good. And you might get some shedding. And when you're really professional and you're selling your work, you do have to like provide that type of, you know, option for people. But if it's just your own work and you're wanting to frame it, you can just put a mat over it. The only thing it's preventing is in that mat, that lip. So if you have a mat in here, and that's on your paper, that mat could get some of this pastel in that little lip that hangs up if it sheds down. I mean, usually I tap off everything, I go out and blow it off, I hit the back of it. It's very little pastel. And you know, like you can see, let's see if I can get a piece of paper. So like this one I can show you, this is what it looks like. And so I'm putting it on that green. It doesn't really come off a ton, you can see. So your mat will have that on it, and you know, you'll have to cover up some of your work. So you can just frame your own DIY. The frames I'm gonna show a video, I order custom from my local framing shop, and I do it myself because I like to do stuff like that. I'm a DIYer. So I taught myself how to frame. So I'm going to try to get a YouTube video in it. If it's not a full video, it'll be a short. But I really want to try to film my class this weekend. But I also want to get some of my pieces in the store. So I carried that through. And right here, I kind of broke up a little bit because I didn't want it too heavy. And then I think I really like where that's going right there. And so I'm going to pick another color to work with and see where we go with that. And I might choose a violet, or I think I'm playing around. I'm ending up with, I think I need to hit and go teal, or I'm gonna be, let's see here. This has got a lot of red in it. I'm gonna switch to a different wand. I just got to start laying the color in. Because I've already hit the magenta. I've already got the red in there. So I think what I'm going to do is I might even hit some of this in there. Why not? And I usually on the color like this, I'm not going to put it in a really heavy spot. Now, turquoise and pink, oh, that got a little green on it. So it turned, this is the turquoise core. And I didn't think I had anything on this tip. Let me see here real quick. I got some green on there. Let me just flip it because I don't have the patience. Let So these are complementary colors. So I'm bumping them up together. That pink and that turquoise. And then I think I might just start laying in some pencils after I block in a few more. Let's see, what time are we at? 3:02? Are you guys kidding me? It goes by so quick when we're having fun. Lots of action going on out there today. My dog is. So this color, the one thing with it is I love using this pencil. I'm going to show it to you. It is this 545, and it's a little greener, so sometimes I'll tap in a little bit of this permanent green to make it match my pencil. And if I don't, then they don't really match. And I really like using this pencil throughout. And I've just learned that over time. So
is it sticky on both sides against the glass and the art?
No, the spacers are only sticky. They have a little like sticker that you just peel off on the one side. And if you guys want, I can go get a spacer real quick and show it to you. Now, I have to buy the spacers in bulk, but you can go into your local frame shop and get a spacer. Most of them carry them. So I'll have the spacers linked.
Okay, I'm gonna probably hit that in a few spots. I really like peach and this together. I'm gonna probably carry this on down here a little bit. I might just do this. I want this to be more broken up.
So you can see how that is a little bit different than this color right there. And then I'm trying to think of where else I want to tap. So I usually will tap something three times. I might hit this little swirl, but I might end up having to do that with, I have a piece here I'm just referencing. It might be fun to do this in here. Because we have that pink down here. So I'll catch up on chat here in just a sec. And even if this covers up some of my gold more than I want, I can always go back and put it in again. But like I said, I want to start making them feel like they're part of each other. And I'll be able to tie in this color down here maybe a little bit. Let's see what you guys are doing on chat here. Welcome, everyone. Just so glad everyone's here. I know not all of you guys chat, so I'm just really glad that you're here. Worried about them sticking. Awesome.
Oh, I'm glad you guys are liking it. The pan pastels are such a unique pastel medium. It applies so differently from other pastels. I love it. Yeah, Phoenix, that's why I've just loved it so much. And it definitely keeps my interest because the possibilities are really endless with it. You can do so much with it. It's pretty amazing. Paint and Puzzle, welcome. I'm so glad that you came today. I've seen you in some of my other lives. Laura, I haven't opened mine since I got them. It looked like it was on both sides. Sorry to bug you about this. I'll just be brave and do it. Oh, you're so cute. Yeah, you just open them up and it's... I'm going to have a little video on it soon. So definitely that will be fun to share. Okay, so I'm thinking about bringing in... I'm just going to bring in some violet. And I've used that throughout, so this is going to tie it in. Thinking I want to go like an orange there or a green. I just have to get brave and lay these colors down. The other thing to think about is when choosing colors, a lot of times I'll go dominant with one color. Like I'll have more red in there and the rest will be more supportive. So my goal was to get all of this blocked in today. I really want to leave with that. So the one thing with these lives is it helps me just make decisions. No, I'm not going to, I'm going to do that with the teal, I think. Okay. So I'm going to use a lighter wand and I'm going to bring in some of this orange. And I think I'm going to go with the orange shade. So if I worked just in one spot and then just kind of went through the piece, it wouldn't look as balanced because part of my, you know, flow, my creative workflow is dappling those colors all throughout. And that's how I think the piece will end up being harmonious in the end. Let's see here. We got, thank you so much. I appreciate your compliment, Paint and Puzzle. Gotta get brave with the color. Yep. I'm always worried all my faces will look like clowns, but she's fabulous. Thank you. Yeah, we do have to get brave, you know, like, I think it's just the clowns. I've honestly had that same thing. So, you know, realize that's just natural. I've had a few pieces. I have the one that you guys have seen, the grow one. And I was all worried. I'm like, does that look like a clown? But I mean, you know, you just gotta, the cool thing is you can erase with pan pastel. You're not really stuck with anything permanently, right? So, oh, hey, welcome, Ivy. I'm so glad that you stopped in and said hi. Time goes by so fast. We just saw each other. We were at coffee together this morning. So glad to be able to catch up with each other. All right, so I'm thinking I really like that orange up there. And now I'm thinking about where else I want to put that. I'm gonna go and bump it up against the
up against these colors. Yeah, I'm really grateful that Ivy and I live in the same town. We actually met on Instagram. Gosh, I think it's about 6 years ago now. And yeah, we love our coffee dates.
Thank you, Michelle. I appreciate all your support. Don't forget to click that like button and subscribe button and comment on the video when it gets uploaded to YouTube. Yeah, after, like, you can't do an extra comment. My husband and I were talking about that until after the live is shut off, and then you can go put a comment on the video. So yeah, if you come back, watch the replay, anything like that, and you can put a comment, that really helps. It's a free way to help and support my channel growing. I'm really excited. It's been growing really quickly, and I'm really enjoying this, sharing all of this with you guys. So you're going to start seeing the what I'm hoping before we leave is you're going to start seeing some of those colors that I put into the face are going to be reflected in the hair. And I'm not trying to get it all perfect in here because I know I'm going to go in with pencils. And so I really feel like this orange has tied in some of the face, and it really has made it, you know, it's starting to harmonize. Laura, did you just do a super chat? I'm so excited. Thank you so much. Oh, you're awesome. Okay, you guys, you can like it, you can heart it. It's interactive. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. It's your first super on a live stream. That's awesome. Thank you so much. I really appreciate the support. You're talked about. Whenever you do super chats, you're definitely a topic of conversation in our house. My husband was so cute when you guys did the super chats last week. He was all running into my son's room going, "They did a super chat." So I don't know what my kids think sometimes, like their parents sitting here online doing all this stuff. But thank you so much. That made my day. I really appreciate it. It's a great way to support me. So thank you so much. Made my day. That's awesome. Okay, so I'm going to hit this in one more spot here. Like even down here, like I'm starting to get that urge to start layering. But you can see how I could bring that orange in up there. And I'm going to start layering that in. But I'm just trying to think of all the spots where I want the orange. I think I might reserve this. I got to think of what color I'm going to want in there. I might go some greens, or maybe I'm looking on the screen because sometimes that really helps. I think I'm going to put the orange right here and see if I can get these to be happy friends. So this one is starting to wear out on me. It's, you know, got where it's driving me a little batty. So, yeah, Ivy, you got to witness a super chat. That's cool, right? I was telling Ivy about him. She wasn't here on the last live, so that's so much fun. Happy little friends, a la Bob Ross. Oh yeah, I'll be the Bob Ross of Pan Pastel. Wouldn't that be a dream? Oh my gosh. Bob Ross is awesome. Love Bob Ross. I have a Bob Ross t-shirt. Okay, so you can see how that's starting to kind of come together.
I'm
thinking I'm gonna put this orange right here in this real dominant, like, bright spot. It's a pretty focal point, but I really don't care. This is where, you know, people ask me about rules. And I'm like, no, I love this. I'm putting this here, even though this is my, you know, focal point right here. I just love this kind of vibe right here.
So cool. Francine, I never knew what the super chat was. I'm a dinosaur. Well, you know, the cool thing, Francine, is I just got monetized for it. You have to have like 3,000 watch time hours to get monetized to be able to have the super chat feature. Now, when I was on Twitch doing research, thinking I was going to go to Twitch and live stream, they have all kinds of features like that. But here you have to earn the privilege to use them and have them. So right now I have super chat and super thanks, I think is what it is. No, super chat, and there's three of them. And then I'm almost to the next level where I'll be fully monetized. So the cool thing is a lot of people don't get to use those cool super chat features because they're not live streaming. I'm going to go in with a pencil here. So the live streams are who gets these type of super chats and everything. And so when you click on the money icon there, you're not committed to anything. So don't be scared. You can go in there and look at what it is and check it out. There's no commitment or anything, but it's kind of fun to see all the different things that are in there. But I used to be so scared when I was on Twitch that whatever I touched, something was going to happen. They're a little bit more interactive over there. So I'm excited that there's some more engagement. So the next thing I'm going to set up is membership thing. I don't know what I'm going to do yet, but you can get extra perks. So I can go get some like special emotes and emoji type stuff that that members can have and things like that. So it's going to take a little bit of time to set that up. I didn't really realize what was all involved until I started reading about it.
So I've got that orange in here. It still looks a lot like, you know, stained glass. It's really choppy. It'll still be that way until I get all the blocking in done. And I'll probably put I'm trying to think of where else I might want to put that orange, but I'm just going to keep it like that so I can see if I can get maybe the rest blocked in here. Stacy, rules. We don't need no stinking rules. I know. I didn't know either. I needed to look it up. Yeah. Francine, you guys are funny. We're all older in some ways. Like, I swear, if I didn't have teenagers, I would be like lost. Okay, so I'm going to pull in some greens and let's see here, finding my right wand that I have one that I've pretty dominated with greens, and I'm going to start pulling in some of this permanent green. I don't want to go with the pencils all in yet. The pencils sit on top of the paper a little differently, so I do like to put as much in as I can with the pan pastel. It's kind of like an underpainting for the pencils. So I'm just thinking here, like, I want to blend this. I'm using the core permanent green. Probably going to leave a little gap here because I don't want that to get too muddy. I'm mixing this with the shade because it's going out to the edge and I don't really want this to be super bright right there. And I'll probably just blend these together. And then I might go for the whole sunburst thing. Whenever I get inspired, I'm just going with it. So I got this right here. I'm using that yellow oxide. Whoops. This is a really torn up one too.
I really like the idea of this being like a sun. I might change this center color, but I don't know. We'll see how I feel. The center color might be cool as white. Now, since I have so much gold in here, sometimes I don't feel the need to use the yellow as much because there's already a lot of gold. So yellow is the complementary of violet. So bumping those together to make friends can be really contrasting and interesting. So the other thing is the piece is really warm and these little cool violets, like this is a warm violet and this is a cool violet, play off of each other and add interest. I think I'm going to go bold and do a green up here because I think that's going to tie in this fern that's kind of heavy, and I can always layer over it and merge it together with oranges and things like that. Oh, we got someone new here. Welcome, Carrie. Well, no, I think you've been here before. West Australia. Yeah, it's super early in Australia. I heard that your guys' time change just happened. There's a few of you Australians that I used to have at the beginning, and now the time change has been a lot harder. So I'm glad that you're here, Carrie. Welcome. You're a lovely dinosaur. You guys are all so sweet to each other. You're going to feel young, you know, learning all these things. I always think, you know, the dinosaur thing, as long as we're still learning and open to learning, even with art, I feel like that kind of helps this whole getting older thing. You know, like I just really, my goal is to really stay open and to learn. And I'm thinking that's going to really, I want to keep me young, you know, like, it's uncomfortable. And I think that's the hardest thing, is that we still got to be willing to get uncomfortable, even with our art and learning and doing things and being okay that we might not be good at it right away. But I'm hoping when I'm 90, you know, in my 90s, I'm still doing young things. I don't know. Yeah, growth rarely feels comfy. That's so true. I'm going to use a little bit of this Hansa yellow. I'm just going to put it over this. It's just in between that. I don't know. I don't want that to be all... My other piece, I used a lot more blues, and so this is a lot warmer. What? Oh my gosh. You're awesome, Peg. Dang, girl. Thank you so much. Woo-woo. Peg does the super chat. That's awesome. Well, we get to interact with it, you guys. You can give her some love. We can heart it and thumbs it up. Peg, you're awesome. You've been to almost every live. There's a handful of you that I just really appreciate all of your support on this journey. It's really meant a lot. And thank you so much for using that today. That is so cool. So cool. Wow. Well, you sure know how to make me smile. I mean, this is fun already. I did not go in thinking about that feature and stuff. Like, my main goal here is to connect with all of you on this journey. And I talk about this all the time now. I'm just like probably the happiest I've been doing this journey. And I think just it was missing being able to connect with and share my art and share my journey. And it's been so much fun. And I'm excited for this community to build up, and you guys are a big part of that, so thank you. So I'm gonna go until I have this hair blocked in today, So just so you know, it might be a few minutes over. I'm just gonna get to this spot because I want that next session to be where we are diving in and we are throwing down the pencils. So I really love the pencil throwdown. That's what I've been calling it. And I'm not gonna get there unless I get this all blocked in.
Oh, this is just awesome. You guys are awesome. Thanks for supporting, Peg. All the likes. That is so awesome. Thank you so much. I love that touchdown emoji. I haven't missed a live yet. Yeah, you've been to every single one. There's a few of you. There's a few of you. That's why my heart was kind of broken when I heard that Australia's time, they had their daylight savings time this week. So now it's 6:30 a.m. there. And when we started this out, I think if I'm right, correct me if I'm wrong, when we started this, it was 8:30. So then we had a time jump, and now they have theirs. So it's, I was like, oh, so many of you guys have been coming.
Well, Stacy, I'm so glad that you're here. Maybe I'm gonna call that. I'm gonna put the title on the thing. It's the pastel pencil throwdown. I'm gonna put it in quotes. And all of you who come, and even those of you who watch my replay, join us for the pastel pencil throwdown on Tuesday next week. Okay, I'm really starting to enjoy these greens and how they're moving in here. I'm looking at it and observing here. I do feel like I think I kind of want to go more reds for the finish because I can pink those out and put them into peach. So I also think I'm missing. I'll put one more green right here. And I'll have to do that with pencils. And then I'm gonna probably go black in here. I wanna put, well, those are right next to each other. I think I'm gonna do this. This is just spontaneous, but so the reason why I'm doing this is because I want my dots. I have one there, I have one here. And then I don't want to put one right there because it's like straight across and I don't want it to compete with the eyeballs. So I'm gonna have to find another spot maybe for my dot. And I might just do that. I might just make one up because I want the spot to be what I want it to be. And so I don't want them to be in the line with something. And I think right here is there's too many. So there I got some dots throughout. And now I'm gonna put in some more reds. Stacy, it's fun when you're here. You guys are all so supportive to each other. This gal's really coming together. Yeah, I think she's getting there. We're gonna be caught up where she's got all her blocking in done. Okay, on the weekend, West Australia is different for you. But like the states where they're different times throughout. Okay. You tell it who's boss. Okay. You guys are awesome. Okay, so I'm gonna go pretty bright red right here. I could go in with pencils. See how that's kind of balancing that flow out a little bit? I'm thinking about putting some right next to her eye. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my little wand here. Because this is my focal point, I think that might look kind of cool. I can always change it. There is a shadow going in right there. Now that I put this down, I might regret that a little bit, but I'm going to just see. I think I like it. I can't wait to show you guys how this is all going to start coming together. And especially for those of you watching the replays and everything that you're not here live, the next stage is really, I think, the most powerful. So it's where all those details come in, and it really brings the piece together. I feel like well, I'm just going to have to go with that. I kind of want to put more red somewhere here. And I think what might be cool is it's probably going to be a pencil thing where I end up pencil lining something in over here. And I'm going to bring some in here. I think that line's probably going to be red. I might go red right here. Do you remember if you had put a blue down in the eye before the green? I just adore those eyes. No, I didn't put any blue down. I just put green down. I always like to give my women green eyes. I think if there's anything I might change, it might be some of the blocks later, but we'll just see because I'm... So I know my son comes home at like 3:45. So just be prepared that is when my dog will bark. He might even come and say hi because I don't think he might read the sign on the door. He's 16, so reading the sign might be... Okay, so I might save that for pencils. Yeah, in the eyes, I put a little bit of the greens down, and then I did pencils over them. I'm not loving that cool purple, so I might just see where that goes. And I'm trying to think of what other color I want to pop into these spots here. Maybe if I put a couple dots of the green in there, that might tie these together a little bit. And then I'm going to have to think about, oh, I got those muddied together, so I'm flipping that. So what I do after I do these lives, and even when I'm painting on my own, I a lot of times will take a photo of my piece. And then I just stare at it, and it really lets me process what I might want to change. And I'm not probably going to do big changes, but it just lets me go, okay, well, I just had to get that color going. I had to lay that down. Let me see what I want to do with that. So it's almost like this could have been gold. But I think I want at least one line to be its own thing. It might be really cool to bring in.
Yeah, I got a few things that I'm trying to work out. So I might sit with that.
Up here, I'm going to put...
Oh, that one's a little... I got the wrong... Yeah, there's a few colors I'm hem-hawing about, but I think once I start putting pencils in, I think it's this, you know, I'm just going to do it. I'm not sure about this. Let me just change this one. I don't think I mind keeping it warmer. I like that better already.
Well, we're doing what we're doing today, people. And it's okay if that spot peeks out a little bit. I'm fine with that. Like the purple is just a hint. Because I just have hints of that purple in here. So maybe toning it down and not having it be so dominant will make it even, you know... So I think you guys are really witnessing I'm in flow right now. I don't want to stop it. I don't want to like restart this moment. And I'm just going with it. So. I really am digging the red. So I'm going to go with that. And then you get to see this change right now. I'm a little hard on my tools today. So when I'm live, I have so many things I'm juggling that I've realized I'm pretty hard on my tools when I'm live. So thank goodness they're not very expensive. Okay, I'm going to catch up on chat here in just a sec.
Awesome, Phoenix. I hope you have a great day. Thank you so much for all your support. Yeah. Okay, everyone's saying goodbye to Phoenix. Have a great day, Phoenix. I'm so glad that you came. So... I really think I like that a lot better, and also keeps the shadows a little bit more into the violets, because, you know, maybe if I was using that off in the end, I think what I'm going to start doing is I'm going to be bringing in more of the dark violets here, and that's going to bring that out a little bit more too. So I feel like this spot, I'm pretty good, and then I can maybe put a little... Maybe even do the skin tone like this. Use this burnt sienna. Yeah, I think going more warm is the answer. And I also think I want to put some fuchsia right here. And so I'll see how I feel about the, there's turquoise. I think that's going to work a lot better now when I put that throughout. And then I'll come up with what I want to put around this. I don't think I want to put red around that. That might be kind of cool. But, and then I'll just play with it. So I think I'm going to let myself sit with these colors right now. And then when I come back, I won't have a ton to have to change up too much. So I'm going to check chat here. I'm a big fan of gingers. Back when my hubby was a boy, he had stocking red hair. Oh yeah. She's going to have that redhead vibe. And I'm excited to see how she develops even more. The more I look at the camera, even small on here, I think once I build up the skin tones and work on that, I just want to be able to have enough time for that on our next one, but I'm going to go with the flow, right? So you guys have made this another amazing experience, and I'm pretty stoked. Like, what a great day. Thank you guys for your support, your super chats. Definitely, if you can give a thumbs up to the video, I really appreciate that. And your watch time helps. So, and then if you haven't signed up, sign up for my free Pastel membership library on my website. I've pinned the link. And I also have a Facebook group. So I have that in the description link below. If you do work or in any medium, you can definitely come. It's for everybody. And I just want to thank you so much for being here. Yeah, Lynn, see, you can see that the cool violet was just a little much. So I might come back and make a few more little additional changes before I start merging it all together. So Temple, awesome. Thank you so much. Laura, your granddaughter has red hair. We always say the hair is a warning. She's the tiniest, but a daredevil. She spent her spring break skiing black diamonds. Dang, she's a risk taker. That's awesome. So you watch it live and then on the big telly later. That's awesome. Thank you so much. I know my head's like this big on there. It's like real life. We've put it on downstairs. So thank you guys. I'll see you next Tuesday. And I'll have a before and after too for the stages next week. So I think that'll be fun. And we'll see if this merges into two parts next week or just one. I'm just going to go with the flow. I'm not going to fight it. And but thank you for all of you that showed up, and I really appreciate it. So take care. And Michelle, I'm going to miss you so much. I hope that you'll be able to pop in every now and then. And thanks again, everyone. Take care. All right. Bye.